Hey guys, Nolan here. Today, we're continuing our Bully series. Yeah, you thought we forgot about this one, right? Yeah, no, not a chance. Bullies are everywhere in the horse industry. Some are in the mountains, some live under bridges. But today's bullies live in real houses. They walk the streets as easy as hookers at midnight. Hey, they may be your bestest friend. Actually, they probably are your bestest friend, and you feel inferior to them. Because they make you feel like you know absolutely nothing about horses. And they know everything. Yeah, we're talking about the know-it-alls. Woo! What a rant. So who are the amateur know-it-alls? In a previous video, which I'll link to right up there, I introduced the general idea of what the know-it-all bully type is. They're the ones who have read countless books and can recite our omnibus like it's the back of their freaking hand. Majority of the time, they can't ride even if their life depended on it. But they're going to scrutinize your every flaw to make themselves feel superior. Because your training beliefs don't coincide with what they think they know. They think very highly of themselves, and why wouldn't they? They have all the answers, you know. They believe their opinion matters. And we should definitely listen to them as if we give a shit about what they think. Not gonna lie, they're a wee bit entitled, and the poor knowledge is rather insufferable very early on in our relationship. Sometimes you just want to take a tire iron to the side of their head. I don't mean that. I do. Okay, Nolan, but how did they get this way? Usually these bullies have been bullied themselves, so it's a learned behavior. Maybe it's been from a former coach. They treated me like crap, so I'm going to treat you like crap, because that's just how the game works. Stupid amateur! Many of the know-it-alls I've come in contact with live very miserable lives. They usually have no friends. I mean, who would want to be friends with somebody who belittles them all the time? They've been told they're wrong so many times that they are tired of feeling that way. So they find a source, whether it's through a book or a magazine, gather all the answers so that they will never be wrong again. And then they cling to those answers like it's a lifeline. But there's a frustrating part with this mindset when reading these books. First, let me say I'm completely for reading books and articles and bettering our knowledge and a better understanding for our sport. But, like anything, there has to be balance. And know-it-alls very rarely have it. They're gonna be the first ones to say,
in the book it says.
What they don't seem to understand is that the book's usually talking about the finished product, what we're aiming to achieve. I'm sorry, Karen, you're not going to get a baby to do perfect strike-offs to the canter every single time. So you decided you're going to introduce Tempies today? You do know you're not getting right off the bat, right, Karen? You and the horse are going to have boo-boos. Sometimes the horse struggles. Sometimes the rider struggle. Sometimes both of them struggle. That doesn't automatically mean that you as the rider did something wrong or that the horse did anything wrong. Welcome to training. But because of this mentality, it's no wonder why these know-it-all amateurs struggle so much with their day-to-day riding. Unless they bought a schoolmaster, their horse isn't going to fall under what they classify as the right result, right then and there. Then there are the other know-it-alls that are on the other side of the wall that have never been told in their life that they're wrong. Everything they do, A-plus material. Their coaches kind of always patting them on the ass, saying, you're amazing. Because they want their money, which by the way, I have a whole video on that topic right there. Or it's because the only people they've surrounded themselves with are people who don't really know that much. Either way, it inflates an ego. I mean, just imagine in your whole entire life, you've never, ever been told you were wrong. Of course you'd think you knew everything. Are know-it-alls so eager to spread their knowledge because nobody has ever asked their opinion before? And is that the reason why they want to give it to you, whether you asked for it or not? Ponder that one. This then leads us into the third type of know-it-all, which is the know-it-all that is scared to be wrong. One know-it-all I met had been treated so poorly when she was a kid. Her mother would say she was a terrible child and how she ruined her life, yada yada yada. But now, 20 years later, her mother wants to join the horse riding world and looks to her daughter for all the answers. Her mother looks to her daughter when something's gone wrong. Daughter feels a sense of self-worth. She finally has her mother's approval, something she's been waiting decades for. It seems great, but in reality, it's the thing that turns her into amateur know-it-all. If something happens to her mother's horse, and her mother asks her for help, the daughter is going to say something that she believes is the right answer. Everything is fine if it's the right answer, but what happens if she's wrong? She'll lose her mother's approval. She can't have that happen. She's wanted this for years, so now she makes it so she's not wrong. Farriers, vets, massage therapists, all the people on your team, they're all wrong. She's right, because if she's wrong, She loses everything and is seen as the failure again. Okay, great. So how do we deal with these people, Nolan? There are a few things you can do, but I'm going to be completely honest with you. It's not going to be easy. Do you honestly think a know-it-all is going to allow you to take the higher ground, make them look like an idiot, and allow it to be easy? No, they're going to play dirty and going to do everything in their power to make it seem like they know the most. This is their life after all. But here we go. I'll give you a list of things you're going to have to do. Ready? First thing you have to have in your mind is you have to be the one to take the high road all the time. And I will not lie, this, in my opinion, is the hardest thing to do when dealing with a know-it-all. These know-it-all trolls are under a bridge and they're throwing mud at you. And I'm being nice by calling it mud. Your objective is to cross the bridge. No going around it and trying to evade them, they will chase you down. No going under the bridge and fighting fire with fire. You're crossing that bridge come hell or high water. So how do we do it? First thing, ask them to lead by example. The funny thing about these bullies is they have quite the ego. Don't they all? And they're gonna hop on it. Say you're working on a leg yield and you use some counterflexion to realign the outside shoulder.
But now?
I know, Karen. I'm sure somewhere in this book it tells you how a leg yield is supposed to have some inside flexion. But guess what? We're training right now and we're thinking long term.
But in the book it says...
Well, why don't you get on your horse and show me how it's done then? One of two things are going to happen. Either they're going to give you an excuse of why it can't be done, whether it's the horse is off today or they have a chiropractor appointment or something. They're always going to have an excuse of why they can't do it. Which you then can pretty much say, well, I'm a visual learner, so we'll wait until you can show me. Which will be, like, never. Or they're going to puff up their chest. Challenge accepted. Game on. I've had this happen to me, and if you're interested to see how it went, there's a video right there about it. The bully is going to get on their horse and trying to show you how it's done. And chances are, they're going to show you everything you shouldn't be doing. Horses are humbling guys. And usually when you go to show something off, the horse kind of screws you over. They ain't in for that. Now, if that doesn't meet your fancy, I have step two you can try. You get to be like me and say, I already have a coach, thanks. And they're rather qualified for the job. And then when the know-it-all tells you that your coach is teaching you wrong, you get to simply say, well, next time she's here, I'll introduce you to, and you can have a little tongue wag, huh? They won't agree to that, because know-it-alls are really cowards in the grand scheme of things, so... But let's say we have an extra one who does get confident. Your coach probably already knows how to deal with the know-it-all, and knows how to take them down a peg or two. Third thing you could do, which my mother taught me, and it works wonders, tell the know-it-all you'll settle it in the show right. If the judge agrees that the know-it-all is as fine as the cat's ass, they'll judge accordingly, and usually that doesn't happen. There is something amazing about stepping out of the ring with a 75 and a know-it-all, a 49. And the final thing you can do with a know-it-all, and by all means, you can skip right to this one right off the bat. Cut off the conversation before it even really starts. I mean, you can see when a know-it-all is walking your way, their body language, their tone, just how they look at you, you're in for something. So, chop it off like that. We're done here. Keep walking. Ain't nobody got time for your bullshit today, Karen.
Squawk, 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 squawk.
Yeah, you keep squawking. Just use the door. Bye. And that's pretty much everything I have on know-it-alls, but I'm going to leave you with one final thought. Know-it-alls love to be fountains of information. Their faucets never turned off because how would the world keep going without their wisdom? But the thing is, people who need to fix people with their info usually need to fix themselves. You'll notice that a lot of the people who have gone through this, who have the knowledge, who have the experience, aren't about to start blabbing on about their opinion. The ones who know understand how hard it is to do it the right way, understand how training takes time and patience, and that every single time you sit up there, it's not perfection. These people are not going to be the ones to look down on you because they themselves have gone through it. They know how hard it is. They're not going to say anything when you or your horse is struggling because they've been in that exact same spot. But the know-it-alls have never and will never leave their current position. They'll never learn more. They'll never grow. All they know and ever will know how to do is how to parrot information in an attempt to make it seem like they know what they're talking about. In hopes that somebody, anybody, will look at them and think they have a clue of what the hell they are trying to talk about. And now it's on to you. What did you think of today's video? How do you deal with the know-it-alls? And how many know-it-alls have you come in contact with? Let me know down below. And while you're at it, if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. As I've said before, and I'll say it again. It's a little thing, but it really does go a long way. And if you haven't already, why not hit the subscribe button and join the Little Cruiser Guild. We have new videos up every week for your entertainment, but also to make this horse world make a bit more sense. And that's pretty much everything I've got for you guys today. All right? Thank you so much for watching. I am Nolan Michael Cruz, and I'll talk to you later. Ciao!